I think this is an air bubble. So we're gonna fix that. And I think I'm just gonna add some leaves from my last carving. And I'm just gonna hide it. Oh, this is this position. Okay. I'm gonna wet these. And I'll wet this one because they're a little dry from sitting over. I need to spray them. I keep a spritzer. Okay. Keep everything damp that I need to leave out, you know. So these leaves need to tell a huggable story. I think maybe like this would be good. Okay, let's get this guy down first. I made that super wet. You hear my fan going? I don't like to run the AC down here in this part of the house. It's so expensive. I like to conserve energy, and and does it for me and save on my electricity bill. Never hurts to save money. Oh, that's cute. Then I want them to kind of overlap like so. So I'll put my line here and then there. So what I'll do is take this one off, go ahead and score here. And hope I remember how I did this, because I am bad for that. But you know, it always works out in the end. Just be diligent and keep working. Clay has a tendency to become what it wants. You can start off with an idea, execute it all the way through, and right at the end, Mother Nature decides I wanted something else. That's just my theory anyways. Not always so. But don't be hard on yourself if you can't manifest your ideas in your head into your pieces yet. The days will come when the time is right, but right now, when you're learning, you go through all these different learning experiences which are crucial in your pottery journey. So please make mistakes or allow yourself to, and understand that it's okay. This is a slip I made from a previous video. I don't want to use too much. Now, in college, our professor made us add vinegar to it. I haven't done that in a while. I just haven't, because this sticks just fine, and the vinegar seems to make the clay slip a little whiter. Could be in my head, but, you know, whatever. Is that the overlapping one? I think I got that. Did I get that all wrong? No, I didn't. Okay. Follow your guides. I think I was... we'll just keep going. I just got totally confused there. And that's okay. Just keep moving, because in the end, it'll all work out. Watch your fingernails. You want to make sure you get those edges, because can cause you some problems later. Now, I don't know what I did, but that's totally not how I set it up. I think I did them upside down, but it's okay. Because the beauty of this is that I can adjust it however, whenever. Yep, totally got it upside down. And that's okay. It's kind of late. It's like 1-2 o'clock a.m. But I'm a night owl, so that's okay for right now till work starts back up. So there's a beautiful little overlapping there, and it looks so messy, but that mess is what's going to allow me to smooth and beautify it. See? Because I kind of want to look like a relief, not so much, you know? That looks like the upside down tulip. It probably would have been a good tulip. Maybe I'll try that on another piece. And I may do this to the other side. And I'm doing this because it looks nice. And because there was an air bubble in that clay. This is some recycled clay. And I threw this very soft, so I developed some air bubbles. And that's okay. Just keep it moving.
Hi, Mom.
Hi. You about to what? Oh, okay. Sorry, y'all. I have a whole family over here. They're all grown, but the boys still come just to say hi while I'm videoing. So bear with them. They are some cute individuals. They're musicians, and we were laughing because my son did a video today that got like 100,000 likes, and I was like, wow, I've had a video up. You should be proud of me. My video has been up for a week and I've gotten 6 likes on it. And we got a good laugh off that, but I'm just here to share what I love, and hopefully somebody can benefit from it. And because of work, it's over the years, it's been hard for me to be consistent with my pottery, because I don't work in the summers, but in the fall and winter, I am swamped. And you don't want that harsh line, so just smooth it out with a wet brush. Or a brush with some slip, either way. I could put more lines in there, but I kind of like that. See, now I'm gonna take these harsh edges off and round them a little by rubbing. That just worked out fine. Air bubble hidden. If it pops, oh my gosh, it should. I've never had one pop. But just so you know, if it does, what a great experience. Now, I always sign my name with a pencil. Oh, I got some slip right there. And just gentle, just enough to make a mark. All right. That's cute. Frayed my edges a little, but not much, just got some excess clay. Make sure your wheel head is clean. Here's something that got in the clay. I don't know what it was. It didn't cause any type of change in the clay body, the shape, or a hole or a pit. It's probably a piece of brown clay that got in there, but we're gonna leave it because the glaze will cover it anyway. So That's okay. And I think I just rubbed my design with the sponge. I did. Always check here to make sure everything's okay, and be careful not to put too much pressure so you don't get an indention in here. If you do, just kind of rub it out, but not with your fingernail like I just did. Your fingers are the best for doing gentle rubs. Just makes all the uglies disappear. This clay also folded when I squeeze it. You might can see that little line there. But when you glaze it, that'll all go away. It won't go away, but it'll all be out of sight. Swipe you on the bottom. Been having a real problem with wobbly bats, making my pieces uneven, and I kind of just wish I could send them all back and make them fix them. But they are truly uneven. I store them on their side like they suggest, and still having problems. I just had an idea here. I'm gonna cut this off. It's risen. It's a very thin bowl, so I'm putting a lot of tension on it. I gotta be careful. This is gonna be kind of hard to move because it slipped on there really good. No rush. I'm tapping, but with a purpose. Okay. I'm tapping to smooth out any needle marks. I'm tapping to round it off, and I'm tapping to get it to adhere properly. I love saving the bags that I use from trimming. I'll wet them here in this thing and put them in the bag, and the next day I can use it for little stuff like this. Hey, waste not, want not. Always conserve. Kind of wish they had a little more character than just a row there. May have to add one more just to... I'm adding support back here. Yeah, let's just add one more. Probably not a good idea, but let's do it. Let's do two more. one's kind of big. That one's kind of small. I guess a little variety never hurt. Every cherry tree, say that five times. On the tree, they're not all the same size, I guess. There's always some good slip in the bottom of your wheel, too. So I was told in college to always work in odd numbers. That's too cute. So this also, putting decorations on here like this also provides a little bit of a grip, because these bowls can be slippery when wet. So any decoration you put on here, if you don't want to add a handle to a bowl, they help with the grip. That's too cute. That was not my plan, but it is now. See, sometimes things just become. A wet brush will smooth out just about anything. A brush with slip will fill in just about any crack or crevice that you don't want. Some shadows you want, some shadows you don't. Alrighty. There are some leaves with some type of berries. I'm wondering if I should put some on the other side. Maybe. But you see, it left an indention, and all the pressure I put, just give it a little push. And it helped straighten it back out some. I may just leave it like that. I don't know if I need another one. Alrighty. That's cute. It's kind of big. I like it big.